Good evening, everybody, and welcome. This is going to be a wonderful, wonderful event. Tonight's concert is sponsored by the Carl and Dorothy Bennett Center for Judaic Studies in celebration of the Daniel Pearl World Music Days, an international network of concerts that, since this network was established by the Pearl family in 2002, has come to include almost 14,000 musical performances in this year, 140 different countries. These performances use the power of music to affirm our commitment to the promotion of cross-cultural understanding, reminding people of all countries, races, and religions that we share a common humanity. As many of you here know, Daniel Pearl was a Wall Street journalist, kidnapped, tortured, and beheaded in January of 2002 in Karachi, Pakistan, by Muslim terrorists. In 2007, Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, an alleged Al-Qaeda operative, reported to be third in command under Osama bin Laden, claimed responsibility for the murder of Danny Pearl. A 3.5-minute tape of Danny during the last minutes of his life was made by his captors and shown several weeks later throughout much of the world. And again, maybe many of you here saw that tape as I did. This 3.5-minute tape shows his mutilated body, has his captors giving several demands to the US government, and it ends with Danny Pearl's last words. And he said the following: "My name is Daniel Pearl. I am a Jewish American from Encino, California. My father's Jewish, my mother's Jewish, I am Jewish." This year, the Daniel Pearl World Music Days concert, held here at Fairfield University, will be performed by Dan Sachs, singer, musician, and the driving force behind the Sephardic rock band, De Leon. This band is named for the 12th century Jewish mystical philosopher, Moses De Leon, and named as well for Dan's great-grandfather, Giorgio De Leon. His group, De Leon, has recently released their third CD, Tremor Fantasma, which was recorded in Mexico City, and that, as well as one of his other CDs and some other merchandise, will be for sale back at the desk where all of you checked in following this evening's performance. With him tonight is musician, songwriter, and vocalist Amy Crawford, who was one of the original members of the group De Leon. Tonight's concert is dedicated to Daniel Pearl. His life was brutally taken away by those who bow to the gods of hate, fanaticism, and bigotry. He is missed by all of us who believe that goodness and courage can overcome injustice. I'm grateful to Dan and to Amy for being with us. Please join me in welcoming to Fairfield University, Dan Sachs.
That lovely introduction. I'm just going to tune it, then I'll talk to you guys. We've got some songs, some Sephardic songs, some Sephardic stories, and some stories that I'm going to talk to you guys about tonight. Anybody here familiar with Sephardic music, Sephardic folk songs? A fair smattering. Any Ladino speakers? Okay. I'm not sure if it's okay for me to fudge any of the Ladino words that I might have forgotten, but I feel like maybe I'll do my best. Thank you. This first song is called Yoducha Rayonai. It was written by Rabbi Israel Najara in the 1500s in Sfat. And there are literally chapters written on the history of this melody. I mean, it's been traveling back and forth across the world for centuries and has intertwined with Jewish music at various points in that time. It was a popular klezmer song in New York in the 20s. And much earlier as the pizmon that I'll sing for you in a moment. Now, we don't know if the melody was combined with the poem by Najara. He may have heard it in the coffee houses of Damascus at the time, it's possible. Or it could have been added by Turkish Jews much later. The two could have been combined. But anyway, here's how it goes. Yohadu harayonai Adonai roi Yodu harayonai Adonai roi Biyom shabakodesh yom ashivi Biyom shabakodesh yom ashivi Yom asher kilita al kol melachtecha omar ki sarita al kol zulatecha ma'asim asita ein levalotecha liben amatecha chish lehagi. Now here's another version of that song. This one was recorded in 1958 by Gloria Levy, who maybe some of you have heard of. She's a popular Sephardic American folk singer. She learned it from her mother, who was from Alexandria, Egypt, and she learned it from her mother, who was from Asia Minor, modern-day Turkey. And the lyrics, more or less, they tell the same story as the old Turkish folk song Ushkudara, which is we've also recorded. We've recorded three versions of this melody. That's why I'm playing it for so long right now. This version called Fel Shara has lyrics in French, Italian, English, and Arabic. And it was probably performed as a sort of jokey song in you know, having fun with all the multilingual households, because they had come from different lands into these Sephardic communities. So, yeah, see if you can spot some different languages. Fel shara kana bete masa la signorina boyonwa come la duna della sue fascia chi eclaire le boulevard come la luna della sue fascia chi eclaire le boulevard. Volevo parlare a Shatametni because her father was a lagar. E con su ombrella d'arabetni en repense à mon bonsoir. E con su ombrella d'arabetni en repense à mon bonsoir. Perché, my dear, te drabini quando io te amo kitty. And if you want to be near, you palu de nu conquerir. And if you want to be near, you palu de nu conquerir. Toute la notte à l'ambique, et même jusqu'au lever, toujours. And every morning, gastanaki, polez-vous de notre amour. And every morning, hasta aquí, volevo di otro amor. I needed some help from the lyrics for that one, because, yeah, how many languages, was anybody counting how many languages I garbled there? Several, I think. All right, this next one is called Buena Semana, which maybe you can translate. Have a good week. This one would traditionally be sung by Sephardic families in the Balkans, Slovenia, Romania, Bulgaria, at the end of Havdalah, the end of Shabbat. Interesting factoid about this song and about Ladino, the language of Sephardic diaspora in general is, the lyric is, Buena semana, mus del Dio. And the Spanish word for God is Dios. But ever on the forefront of monotheism, the Jews said, you know what, I know that means God, singular, but it's got an S, and I feel kind of, that makes me feel a little bit funny. So let's just make it Dio. So the Ladino word for God is just Dio. And you'll hear that all throughout, you know, Ladino folk music and religious music as well. This is a Sephardic beverage. This was drank by my ancestors before they came to this land and consequently after they arrived. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Salud y vida. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Salud y vida. Que mis hijos vengan al car para maldar la Torah, salud y vida. Para maldar la Torah, salud y vida. Para mal dar con tal asim, para tal dar con tal asim, cola traer los tefilín, salud y vida. Para traer los tefilín, salud y vida. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Salud y vida. Buena semana, mus del Dio. Salud y vida. Ooh, yeah. Thank you. Speaking of traditional Sephardic things, this is a banjo, not a traditional Sephardic instrument, but why not? Actually, an African instrument. It's changed a little bit since it came here, but the banjo is an African instrument. So if you've ever been to Turkey or the Balkans, then you may know what this song is about. It's called La Vida Do Por El Raki. I would give my life for Raki. Has anyone here had Raki? It's a drink, all right. Is that a drink, he says? You know. Me? No. It's like anisette. It's that type of flavor. It's very popular over there, and apparently was very popular with the author of this song. This is a timeless alcoholics anthem. If I think it's up there with All For Me Grog or The Piano Has Been Drinking, Not Me. Mute that. This was one of the first songs that I arranged for De Leon, and I knew the song from this cantor in the D.C. area named Ramon Tassat, who's extraordinary. And I had been working in a restaurant, and I was the only person in the restaurant who wasn't from Mexico, and they had Norteño music on in the kitchen all the time, and so I was just kind of like, I don't know, immersed in this Norteño, which is also, but it's a lot of those songs are drinking songs, and I just thought that this was basically a Norteño song that had lost its way somehow through history, but it should have ended up in northern Mexico, but instead ended up in Turkey or the Balkans. These things happen with songs, but then they find their ways, and then they're in Fairfield, and it's like, how did I get here? And from here, it'll go somewhere else. I don't know. La vida dopo el Rocky, no puedo yo dejarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. Cuando está en el barril, él no habla del todo. Cuando me hago cure candel, me hago baños de lodo. La vida dopo el Rocky, no puedo yo dejarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. Vamos a divorciar casamientos de oro. La vida yo quiero pasar con risas y cañeras. La vida dopo el Rocky, no puedo yo dejarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. Me siento yo y yo varón, me siento yo primario, sin tener lira en el cajón, me siento millonario. La vida por el Rocky, no puedo yo dejarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. La vida no por el Rocky, no puedo yo dejarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. De bebé nunca me harté de tanto amarlo. And just to give you some of the English for that one, tell me if this was not written by an alcoholic who really understood all the highs and lows of the profession. I'd give my life for Rocky. I can't leave it alone. I never have enough of it because I love it so. When it's in the barrel, it doesn't say a word. When I get drunk, I go roll in the mud. Yeah. It makes you want a divorce from even the happiest marriage. It helps you pass your life away with laughter and with tears. I feel like a nobleman. I feel like a champion. Without a lira in my drawer, I feel like a millionaire. Equal parts ode and lament. So we're going to do a song called La Serena, which was the first single off our first record. We made a pretty trippy video for it. It's an extended metaphor, and the song tells a story of a young lover's quest to save a girl who is locked in a tower surrounded by a sea of milk, and then there's boats made of cinnamon, and it's a metaphor, I'm guessing, but in the video we took it literally, and she was
crab.
Yeah, and we also then we went further, and yeah, you turned into a crab. It was, I don't know, ask the director. But anyway, I haven't figured out what all the metaphors are, but there's one thing that gives it away in the second verse, at least I think what the essence of the song is. And it's, so if the sea were made of milk and the boats were made of cinnamon, I would stain myself completely to save my flag. Like I would swim through that messy ocean to save my flag. And it's an ode to the nostalgic homeland of those in the diaspora, Spain. And that is what I believe the song is about, and I've read other people sort of come to the same conclusion. It's one of these songs that has different versions, and ours is off the map. And as far as different versions, we've added some stuff at the end and in the middle, but it's mostly it's a straight translation, and we do it in English and Ladino.
Ah.
Amy Crawford, eh? Right? We'll get to hear more of her singing on this next one, luckily. This one is a duet. It's called Por qué lloras, Blanca Niña, which means, why do you cry, white girl? Which to me was just too kind of great of a translation to leave it in the Ladino. So we went with that. And what it is, it's an argument back and forth between a husband and wife. The husband is a sea merchant, so he spends a lot of his time out on the sea, earning not a lot of money, I think is the implication of the song. So he's away a lot, and he's not bringing home much money. And so they're kind of bickering, and they have kids too, which makes it more complicated. And then the argument comes to an abrupt ending when his mother chimes in that she's so ashamed of him that she hopes he dies. Right? Yeah. It was tough back then. Most of these songs, and this is, I don't know, maybe this says too much about me, but most of these songs are about murder or, alcoholism. And this one too. Why do you cry, white girl? Why do you cry, white flower?
I cry for you, caballero, because you leave me behind. You leave me a child and young girl, small
into my pocket, and I'll give to you 100 gold coins.
What is this enough for?
More than enough for you. It's enough for wine or for bread. Well, if that is not enough for you, I know where I can get more. Da-da-da. City, I
will sell vineyards and fields on the other side of the sea. Mother heard this, she cursed him. She said, "May all the ships of the world sail and return in peace." She said, "May all the ships of the world sail and return in peace." But the ship of my son, may it never return. Amy Crawford. Well, while we're on the topic of murder, let's add adultery to the blend. I don't know if this is, if it's not fair to say this is what all Sephardic music is about. It's just one reason or another, this is what I was drawn to when we were choosing songs for the record. Though not exclusively, there's also songs of praise and Buena Semana, that's Have a Good Week. This one's about adultery and murder. This one's based on El Rey por Mucha Madruga. And it's in English, but I'll paint you the picture. It's the queen is getting ready. She's looking in the mirror, she's combing her hair, and the king walks in, and she doesn't turn around, and she mistakenly refers to him as Angelino, presumably her lover from L.A., I need a rim shot. No? Yeah. There we go. Just kidding. But anyway, yeah, her lover, Angelino. And then when she realizes that she made a mistake, that this is actually the king, her husband, she says, so this is the dream I had last night about this guy Angelino, and I was just kind of telling you about that dream. And the king's like, don't worry about it. Here, and then in the song they say, here's a gift of a white gown and a red necklace, and I'm pretty sure that she's buried in the white gown after they've cut off her head and the red necklace. And so I'm not 100% sure what, I added some stuff at the end.
Mm-hmm.
About the kids. We'll see. The king rises early in the morning and goes to meet his queen. He finds her there with a loosened hair, combing it, trying to look clean with a golden mirror in her hand. She stares at her own precious eyes. The king reaches out and just to caress her, wants to undress her, but gets a surprise. Be still, Angelino.
Angelino, be still.
My first lover, I have two sons by you and by the king to others. Explain this to you with a gift of a white gown and as an accessory. A stain on your collar, we'll call it a necklace. All red and expensive, it cost us our marriage. Your life I dispense with this gift, you can share it. Angelino, beware, if I meet this first lover, I've a gift for him too, beneath the sole of my shoe. And a matching ensemble of chokers and brooches to pin to your chest and poison your oceans. Oh, darn this, my present, call me your tailor. A little stitch here, mind my impalement. My hands are unsteady by what you have done, which reminds me I owe a gift to each of my sons. Be still, Angelina. My first lover, I have two sons by you and by the king to others. Who be still, Angelina. My first lover, I have two sons by you and by the king to others.
Thank you so much. Well, let's hear more. Let's give you a chance to sing something else. This one's called Yo Me Enamoré. Yo Me Enamoré de un aire. I fell in love with the breeze of a woman, with the scent of a woman. And it's a lament for beginning a romantic relationship without the proper lighting. I fell in love with the breeze of a woman so pretty, dearer to me than my heart. I fell in love during the night. The moon deceived me. If it were day, I would not have found love. If I ever fall in love again, I'll do it in the daylight. I guess like indoor lighting wasn't such a big thing.
Say it.
Sigo otra vez mi amor. Di un aire, di una voce muy hermosa.
Hermosa.
Thanks. The next one in my notes, all I wrote is Poland story. So I was living in Mexico City for a few years. We recorded the last record, and while I was living there, I put together an ensemble of all local musicians so I could play shows regularly while I was down there without flying the New York crew all the way to Mexico. And we put together a really solid 45-minute set, because that's basically what we were playing at different clubs around Mexico. And then we got invited to play this Jewish music festival in Krakow, and it's a huge thing. It's like a week long, and we were invited to play the closing stage ceremony, or concert, the closing main stage, as one of the bands on the bill. Mm. My wife says I always do that. If I'm continuing a thought while I'm drinking, I go, mm. Now I think about it every time. It's the worst. We do this tour. We land in Berlin, and then we kind of make our way over to Krakow, and it's, we're playing this 45-minute set kind of every night, and we feel tight, we feel good, and we get to... the main stage, it's our set, and there's 12,000 people there. It's a huge show. It's on televised nationally across Poland. There's these big, like, swooping TV cranes that are like, they're all up in your guitar solo, and it's very exciting. And it's interesting. It's 12,000 people there. I think maybe 12 Jews tops in that whole crowd for a Jewish music festival. It's very surreal. Krakow is. It's an interesting place. And so we play our set, and we do great. We feel real good about it. The crowd loves it. We are walking off stage, unplugging our stuff, high-fiving, and the producer of the concert runs over, and he's like, "You guys have 15 minutes left." And I say, "No, we don't. You told us 45 minutes. We did our 45. We did great. Like, pats on the back. Let's go have a beer backstage and relax." And he's like, "No, we're live on TV. I need you to do 15 more minutes." I'm like... We don't have any more songs, right? Because that band is just, I've just formed them to kind of play this set. I'm just like, all right, guys, I'll do another song. And so I kind of walk very slowly out to the front of the stage. I'm just like in my head, just like, oh, what should I do? Should I do like a Rolling Stones song? Like, what do I know by heart? And so I thought of this song, which is off of our first record, which I hadn't played probably in a couple years. With Ladino, it's like, it's in there, but I like to practice a little bit before I perform for 12,000 people. And so I'm just kind of like reciting the words to this song really fast in my head as I'm walking out. What are the chords? I think it's in B minor. And I pick up the guitar and I play this song slower than I've ever played it before. Not quite 15 minutes. We ended up then, I brought everybody back out and we played our first song again, hoping maybe a few new people hadn't seen it yet. And we're just like, we barely made it out of there. But anyway, this song is called A la una yo nací, and the words are A la una yo nací, at one I was born, at a las dos me engrandecí, at two I grew up, a las tres tomé amante, at three I took a lover, y a las cuatro me casé, at four I got married. Because back then, they didn't have as long lifespan, so things progressed very quickly, and by 4 years old, they were already married. I'm not an expert. You can ask Dr. Ellen later if that adds up, but I'm just...
A la una yo nací, a las dos me engrandecí, a la una yo nací, a las tres me engrandecí, a las tres tomé amante, a las cuatro me casé, a las tres tomé amante, a las cuatro me casé. Alma, vida y corazón, alma, vida y corazón, yéndome para la guerra, dos verdes.
Amazing. I didn't forget the words when I was doing this in front of all those guys, but in front of you guys make me nervous.
Yéndome para la guerra, dos besos al aire di. Yéndome para la guerra, dos besos al aire di. El uno es para mi mamá, el otro es para ti. El uno es para mi mamá, el otro es para ti.
After that whole story, I forget one of the verses. It just makes a lot of sense. It's fine. this next one's called Bar Minan. I don't know. Maybe you guys can help out. Can you say Bar Minan? Yeah, that's it. This was kind of a funny thing, an inside joke in the Mexico band. There used to be a bar in Mexico City called Bar Minan. This song's not about this. This is an expression that means something equivalent to like heaven forbid or God forbid. It's, you know, an exclamation, not a bar in Mexico. This one's, it's from Salonika, and it's a series of short vignettes sung in Ladino, Greek, and Turkish. And the refrain, Barminan, follows each line. And it's a great example of a song that has probably had many verses come and go over the years. The folks would sit around in a cafe or in a house and kind of improvise verses on the spot about something unseemly in their lives or something that they were displeased with, and everyone would respond, Barminan. So, I don't know, an example, a modern day example would be like, I'm not quite in tune. Today I went to the deli, Barminan. I ordered a pastrami on rye,
Barminan.
When they brought me my sandwich,
Barminan.
There was no pickle on the side, there was no pickle on the side, there was no pickle on the side,
Barminan.
Yeah, you can see that. That's the idea. That's my equivalent of, you know, something terrible that could happen. We ate it. Where was our? We got some good sandwiches from one of your local delis today. What was that? The Firehouse? Yeah, a strong sandwich. Thanks. It's good to live in a town with the decent deli, isn't it, guys? This is how you win over people at a Jewish music event. You guys like deli, yeah? Okay. Also, I'll give you a little quote from Pete Seeger, who's a big hero of mine. And I was reading a book that's it's a collection of different letters that he wrote over his lifetime. And there was this paragraph in there which I thought was like a really kind of beautiful way of talking about folk music, which is essentially what we're playing, even though we've kind of put our own spin on it. These are old songs. These are folk songs. He said, a song is ever moving and changing. A folk song in a book is like a picture of a bird in mid-flight printed in a bird book. The bird was moving before the picture was taken and continued flying afterwards. It is valuable for a scientific record to know when and where the picture was taken, but no one is so foolish as to think that the picture is the bird. And I kind of think the same way about, you know, you get something on a recording or in a book with the verses. That's a photograph of that song at that moment. That's not the song. The song has gone before and continues afterwards. There's one verse from this one which was added by Greek Jews on the Lower East Side, which is in English, the girls from Rivington Street. Presumably, this is some. I like to picture somebody like standing between the Streitz Matzah Factory, which is sadly, I think, closing down or just closed down, and the Greek synagogue that's on Broom Street, I want to say. And so they're just standing outside, I don't know, eating matzah or whatever. And they say, the girls from Rivington Street have brought us a new style. When they walk down the street, they wiggle and shake their hips. And, you know, maybe it's a little bit admiring, but it's also a little scolding. Barminan, these girls today with the wiggling. All right. Someone's got perfect pitch, or imperfect. Una hija boba tengo, me la llaman tengeré. Cuando salen a la plaza, me la hacen que pase, me la hacen que pase, me la hacen que pase. No me veas chiquitico. Tengo años sin cupí. Hoy de mí están casados. Tienen hijos al chashi. Tienen hijos al chashi. Tienen hijos al chashi. Austin, Howland, I'm the Yaki. Tengo años sin chushi. Moda nuevo nos quitaron las sillas de Rivington. Barminan, cuando salen a la plaza, se les menea el DJ.
pleasant melody don. Este cortijo, madre, parmina, un fuego quería echar. Parmina, que se queme mi querida, que no endeña a saludar, que no endeña a saludar, que no endeña a saludar, parmina.
There you go. You got it at the end. Let's do it one more time. Ready? No, just kidding. Thanks. What do you say? Let's do one more?
Mm-hmm.
Let's do one more.
Let's do Sephardic folk music's greatest hit. Anybody know what it's going to be? This is probably, I mean, I feel like anyone who's working with Sephardic folk music, they do this song, and it's a great song. But it's sort of it's like an archetypal sad breakup song. So sad, but also kind of like this. It's got a rock and roll element to it. It's Adiós Querida. Somebody got it. You get a free CD. the melody actually comes from Verdi's aria La Traviata. I've read. I didn't figure that out by myself. And anyway, after this, we're going to have a little question and answer. If you guys have some questions, keep them easy. Go easy on me, all right? And we do have CDs and shirts and these little like jogging shorts that, you know, if anybody's needs jogging shorts, then we also have those. You would all look great in them. And if you get those and a CD, then there's a discount. So you got that. Hanukkah's coming up.
Adiós, adiós, querida. No quiero la vida. Me la marcaste tú. Tu madre cuando te parió y te quitó al mundo, corazón ella no te dio para amar segundo. Corazón ella no te dio para amar segundo. Adiós, adiós querida, no quiero la vida, me la amargaste tú. Va, búscate otro amor, va otras puertas, espera otro ardor, que para mí eso es muerto. Espera otro ardor, que para mí eso es muerto. Adiós, adiós querida, no quiero la vida, me la marcaste tú. Yai, dai, yada, dai, dai, yai, dai, yada, dai, dai, yai, dai, yada, dai, dai, dai. Yai, dai, yada, dai, dai, me la marcaste tú. Goodbye, my love. Goodbye, my love. I do not wanna live. Goodbye, 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 my love. Goodbye, my love. I do not want to live. Goodbye, goodbye. Oh,
Thank you so very much. And thank you to Dr. Ellen for inviting us and Rachel for all her hard work. It's been so nice singing and talking to you guys. Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us. What a treat. Usually we've got like a drummer and a trumpet player and a bass player, and they're making all this ruckus. It's really nice to just sit here with Amy and do our thing. Yes. Well, thank you.
Thank you.
You're phenomenal. I mean that. My mother is Italian Jewish. They are on that side. As best as I understand it, we got Inquisitioned to Italy, and we got World War II'd to Connecticut. Actually, they're from New Haven, and now we're just like fingers crossed, like we can stay here on the East Coast for as long as we want to. No more moving due to epic tragedies, but. And my dad's side, my dad's a rabbi, but he is Ashkenazi. His family is Litvak. So that's, there you go.
That's the best.
Is that the best? Jesus, that's the best. What, number one? The Litvaks? Are you Litvak, sir?
Yes.
I do love my dad, so I'll agree. And Amy and I, we met, this is the 10th year that De Leon has existed. Mm-hmm. We just added up backstage and said, whoa, we should do like a 10-year thing. But by the time we get it together, we'll probably have missed it anyway. But this is our 10-year anniversary show, guys. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you. It's great. We met through a mutual friend in the New York City music scene when I was assembling this band. The band, we actually had a record deal with J-Dub Records, which is like an alternative Jewish music label. They had Matas Yahu and Balkan Beatbox and Golem and bands like that. And so I had given them a demo, and they loved this stuff. And then they booked us a show at Bowery Ballroom, which is like a big, beautiful venue in New York. And I, I need a keyboardist. I need a trumpet player. Ah! And we were lucky enough that we got Amy, who can do so very many things well.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Any other questions?
So, Dan, just tell us a little bit. So, how did you come to do this kind of music?
I grew up with a little bit of it in the house. Not that my mother was singing like Sephardic lullabies to me, though there are some, and we've recorded some, but. One, this cantor named Ramon Tassat. I grew up in the D.C. area, and my parents listened to his stuff, and I was exposed to his stuff, and saw him a few times, and I was like, man, this stuff's so beautiful. And then when I was reading through some of the translations of the lyrics, and a lot of it really just felt easy to connect to, not only because they're songs about adultery and murder and alcoholism, but they sounded to me like Johnny Cash songs or Nick Cave songs or just like rock songs that I kind of already was listening to and enjoying. And so just as an experiment, I recorded a few by myself at home, sort of trying to imagine that they were songs that had gotten lost along the way and always were meant to be, rock songs written in Brooklyn in 2006 or whatever. And I thought that they came out good. The first one we did was La Nair Valif Samim, I think was the first one, and then Adio Querida. And I really liked the way it came out. I thought I had something, and so I shared it with some friends, and they were like, yeah, do some more of this. And it kind of grew and grew and grew from that.
Do you have a website with your current itinerary?
We do. We keep our Facebook page the most updated as far as when we have events coming up. Huh?
What do we do?
Oh, good question. It's facebook.com/ILoveDeLeon. I make you type I love DeLeon. And DeLeon is the name of the full the project. Hey, how you doing?
Could you tell us a little bit about some of the other Jewish
things? Sure. I feel like that's thank you for that. I also play in a group with actually some Fairfieldians, a guy named Dave Schneider. He and I and some other guys, we have a kids group, kind of secular Jewish music for kids, kind of like bagels and dreidel birds. Good stuff. Called the Macaroons. Yeah, you love it. It makes great Hanukkah gifts for Yeah, I forget. And then I have another group called the Levies, which is a specifically Hanukkah-oriented band where you only play during Hanukkah, and that's also with Dave and this guy, Adam, from Guster, and another amazing musician named Sean. And I recently, actually, there's one more. God, this list is getting long. So I just got a small grant to create a new project. It's a musically experimental Jewish humanist chanting event. And we just did it for the first time a couple weeks ago at a storefront in Crown Heights, and just got a bunch of people together and sang some chants together, really, me and a group of really wonderful musicians and stuff based on liturgical words and stuff like that. It was really nice just to get people together and sing something. That one's called Segu Lalelo. Come to that Q&A and I'll explain why. Explain that. Yes. Great. As far as we can tell, he's an ancestor of ours. There's a direct lineage between him and so my family name up until a couple my great grandfather was Giorgio De Leon, it was a way, using that name for the band was a way of kind of paying homage to both sides of the family tree, like a distant, branch on the tree and a more contemporary one. And plus, De Leon means from Leon, presumably that's where my family was in Spain before the Inquisition. So it was also a way of kind of a tip of the hat to the like direct roots of the music.
My great-grandfather's family was supposedly from Portugal, but they ended up in Marseille.
There you go.
Huh.
So my family went to Italy.
Yeah.
A lot of them are still there, and then some went to Israel and some came here. But yeah, my grandmother was in hiding there throughout the war and then came here afterwards. Any other questions? Yes, in the back. What does indie mean? That's cool speak for like independent. It's a loaded term and question, which I won't get into all of the implications. But independent historically means not on a major record label, Columbia Records, Atlantic, and it implies that a band is doing something alternative of the mainstream. Nowadays, almost everybody's indie because all the major labels have pretty much have gone under. But it still kind of implies a certain type of sound that's not mainstream radio. And I think I knew when I was getting into Sephardic rock that mainstream radio was not the direction that we were going in. So indie, it's a little redundant to call it indie, but, We don't, no. Maybe, they have a Jewish station, I think. I believe we get played on there. And you can find it on Spotify, et cetera, if you guys. Next week I solo am doing something at the Jewish Museum on 92nd Street. I was asked to choose something in the museum, and then there's like a walking tour, and when people get to that item, I have like a presentation, some kind of musical thing that happens. That's the next thing that's scheduled. And then, the band. I know we have something in D.C. in a few months, but things pop up all the time. Yes. Yeah, well, we can just do this. Let's do the set from the top. It's no big deal. It took us 3.5 hours to get here from New York. So it's possible also to come not that far and still spend a long time getting here. To answer your question, there is live stuff on YouTube. There's, I think, a video from that show. Well, you weren't here for this story, but in Krakow that we played, that will have some very cool camera angles. And then we have some music videos and other live things. If you do De Leon Sephardic, you'll find us. I think if you just do De Leon, you'll get some guy named De Leon. That's YouTube.
Can we get up and dance to you right
now? I saw you. Every now and again, I see somebody's just, it's like their chair is just like, I find them. We usually come to a full band show, and it's a full-on dance party. We played a wedding last weekend, and we don't usually do weddings, but these were fans, and they made like kind of a strong pitch, like, please, like, I think it'll be perfect for our wedding, and we did it, and it was great, and people loved dancing, and it was a lot of fun. All right. Thank you, guys, for all the great questions and for being with us.
Thank everyone for coming this evening, and especially thank Dan, thank Amy. Really, we hope we'll see you again.